settled for nine in the first reserve spot. Moving on to the final individual event today, that is the men's 200 meters individual medley. We are going to have six heats. Heat number one already on the blocks. We have Georgia's Akaki Vashakidze in lane three, then Erik Gitskehold from Norway and Yegor Litvinov from the Ukraine in this first heat. None of them has an entry time. So even though Litvinov is a fast swimmer, he could not be in the seeded heat. So six heats of action, and the eight fastest swimmers, only the eight fastest, will qualify for tonight's final. Litvinov pulling away of the other two in the backstroke. Maintaining the lead. Now the Norwegian in second, with the Georgian third. Six heats in this event. So the seeded heats are the 4, 5, and 6. With yesterday's 400 medley champion Peter Berneck coming later on, and also Britain's Duncan Scott, keep an eye on him, already bronze medalist over 203. So yeah, Litvinov takes this first heat under 2 minutes, but of course no chance for qualifying. However, it was a nice swim by him. So it's time to move on to the second heat. I think Litvinov will be in the lead for a few more minutes to come. But to qualify 2 years ago, it took 1:55.4. And most of the times here in Copenhagen, you need better times than 2 years ago in Netanya to go through to the semifinals or the final of an event. So 1:55.4, it would probably be somewhere around 1:55 to qualify for the final in this event this year. The second heat, we have Malta's Umnov in lane one, then Papastamos from Greece in two, Ludwig, Czech Republic in three, Jean Vital, Portugal in four, then in five, Andersen from Estonia, Arvihjan for the Faroe Islands, Evert Lille, very strong down in lane seven, after the butterfly, then in lane eight, Binard Mahmuti from Albania. Alexander Vita having the fastest entry time, 2:02, his best this year. So they will probably be slower than Litvinov in the previous heat, who went under 2 minutes. Ooh, rather poor turn by Lele in lane seven. Just a few hundredths of a second off the pace of Litvinov, the halfway mark. And and the breaststroke. Vital already overtaking him. Here's the Portuguese fighting for the first spot in the second heat. The first at the turn, and with an incredibly fast 53, he might be able to be under 2 minutes, which would be a great achievement by him. He looks strong, so he might be able to take this heat at the time, just over 2 minutes, 2:00.2, the winning time. Of course, a new best for Jean-Alexandre Vital, but slower than Yegor Litvinov in the previous heat. And here's the start list of the third heat. The crowd getting louder as we have a home swimmer in lane 7, Franz Johannessen. And we also have Lithuania's Povilas Strazdas in lane 4 with a personal best under 2 minutes. Switzerland's Jacques Leufer will be swimming in 3. Adam Halasz, Slovakia, in lane 5. Once again, no semi-finals in this event, with 4 more heats to go. The first 8 swimmers from the morning session will qualify directly to the final. In butterfly on lane 0, we have Ponti from Switzerland in the lead. And that is faster by Litvinov's split by 0.8 of a second. And backstroke, he still holds on to that lead. It's not a rarity that someone wins from an outside lane, especially in the 200 medley. There was Attila Tene at the 1996 Summer Olympic Games in Atlanta, where he won the title from lane 1, surprising the favorites in the middle lanes. But now Ponti is overtaken in the breaststroke. Not a specialist in this discipline, definitely not. So now it is lane 2, Christoph Meyer from Liechtenstein taking the lead. 1:29.00, more than a second faster than Litvinov. So it will be the best result so far in this morning session. Well under 2 minutes. Christoph Meyer from Liechtenstein taking this heat, with Johannessen finishing strong in second position. Poor Ponti is way back, down to 6, the early leader. So Meyer, first time under 2 minutes, even under 1:59. As we move to the seeded heat. So the best 30 swimmers come right now. Five swimmers under 2 minutes in the previous heat. And now to some faster action. In the fourth heat, Simon Sjödin from Sweden taking lane 4. A silver medalist from 4 years ago. A great butterfly swimmer as well. Daniel Pasinkov next to him in five, and Carvalho from Portugal in lane three. Bronze medalist from the previous edition. Portuguese swimmer in one heat. Carvalho in three, Alexis Santos in six, and Gabriel Lopes down in lane number nine. Surprisingly, Sjödin not the fastest over the butterfly. But in the final meters, he's catching up with the leaders. Pasinkov in first. Of course, very fast first 50 meter. And in backstroke, Sjödin taking the lead together with Diego Carvalho. Down in lane seven, Metin Aydin from Turkey in the lead with Benjamin Gratz, the follower of the great Hungarian individual medley traditions, a European junior champion in second. It is still Aydin in the lead. Now comes Carvalho in the silver cap, up in lane three together with Sjödin and Gratz. But it is still Aydin who leads the pack. Now for some quick freestyling, because you cannot save any energy, as only the eight fastest will go through and two more heats are to follow. So Carvalho taking this heat with a time of 1:54. Santos finishing very strong, the other Portuguese in second, edging out Sjödin. Which means Aydin falling back to fourth position. So five swimmers under 1:56 in this previous heat. Two more heats to go. Duncan Scott in the penultimate heat, lane four, the winner of the bronze medal in the 200 free yesterday, also an Olympic and World Championship finalist in the 100 free. Kyle Stolk next to him. He was a finalist at the short course World Championships over 100 meters individual medley. So 20 more swimmers, and currently it is Diego Carvalho with the best time in the heats. Lane four, Scott. Lane five, Stolk. Not the nicest of butterfly swims, but a rather effective one by Duncan Scott. The Stefan Sorak, the early leader from Serbia, a little bit faster the pace as it was in the previous heat. And in lane seven, Sorak extending the lead. Good body length, his advantage. Almost a second on Duncan Scott and Stork. Now to breaststroke. This is where Stork can take over Stefan Sorak. 20 meters to go in this breaststroke. And we have three swimmers really close to each other. Sorak, Stork and Duncan Scott. Stork takes the lead now, but 1 full second slower than the pace of Diego Carvalho. And in freestyle it is still Stork, with Scott catching up with him. An easy swim by the British in the final 10 meters. And almost taking this heat. So Stork followed by Scott. Those two under 1:56. I saw the picture of the meet so far. Six hundredths of a second separating the first two. And we move on to the final heat of this 200 meters individual medley. Two more Hungarians, Daniel Dudas, who just saw in the 100 breast, and Peter Banek, the champion from yesterday's 400 meters individual medley. But the biggest favorite, here he is, the always smiling Philipp Heinz from Germany. Winner of the title 4 years ago, short course world championship silver medalist, and silver medalist behind Banek in over 400 meters. We also have the long course European champion Andreas Vasallos on lane 5. And the early leader is Yaakov Tumarkin from Israel, the backstroke specialist, and also the butterfly specialist Tomil Zanimoto from Norway in the lead now. Philipp Heinz third, Banek only seventh. Yeah, this is completely different swimming 200 IM than the 400 meters. It is much more about speed and great turns. Still in the lead, Tomo Zenimoto. It was Ayos to Martin, Heinz and Banek following them. Now it's time for Heinz to move up a little bit. Still in the lead, Zenimoto. That would be a massive surprise if he could take this one. Still in the lead. And now four swimmers turning on freestyle within a second. Zanimoto to Martin Heinz and also Andreas Vasallos, the long course European champion. It is going to be very fast, a lot faster than Duncan Scott in the previous heat with Karl Stork. So four swimmers looking for qualification to the final of this event. And the final meters, Philipp Heinz taking the lead and touches first the 1:53. Vasallos second, Zenimoto coming in third. And that's a lot faster than in any of the previous heats. So Peter Banek definitely out, the champion of the 400 meters, finishing only sixth in this heat. And probably, yeah, let's wait for the official summary, because this was a very fast heat. But I'm not sure about the qualification of Duncan Scott. Here are the final results. So four swimmers under 155 and the pace of Duncan Scott. So Philip Hines the first and Kyle Stork just in at the eighth position, meaning that Duncan Scott misses the cut by 0.06. Another upset in this morning session. No Duncan Scott in the final of the 200 meters individual medley. One more event, and that is the 4x50 meters freestyle for women. We're going to have two heats: Italy, Finland, Hungary, Slovakia, France, and Poland in this first one. Italy and France looking very strong. However, the biggest stars, Pellegrini and Charlotte Bonnet, are not in the lineup right now. Of course, they want to swim in the final. Down in lane 7, Aleksandr Urbanczyk, the early leader for Poland. Finland and France following. Now overtaking Finland, Malena Niemi. So in lane 3, and also very strong, lane 6, Melanie Hennig, the butterfly specialist for France. And now already in the lead. However, the takeover for the Polish team was, well, it didn't seem to be very good. They might be disqualified. In the meantime, Italy with Yelena Dilido moving up to first spot, followed by France and Poland. Looking strong, the Polish Dominika Standera, and of course Erika Ferraioli for Italy. So Italy takes it with France second, Poland third. But we have to wait to see whether or not Poland will be disqualified because of that bad takeover. Watch out for the camera, ladies. Erika Ferraioli, the fastest in the field with a split of under 24 seconds. We already have the start. The starters of the second heat ready, but still have to wait for the official result from this first heat. So far it is Italy, France, Poland, and Hungary. No official word yet. And maybe it was a little bit too early for the participants of the second heat to undress, because we are still waiting. There you have it, Poland disqualified, which means Italy, France and Hungary, the first three right now. In the second heat, we have Norway, Austria, Turkey, the Netherlands, Denmark, Russia, and Sweden. Sweden looking very strong. but also the Netherlands, Denmark and Russia, always a very good quartet in the sprint relay. Currently in lane 4, the Netherlands, Tamara van Vliet in first. Also up in lane 1, Susanne Bjørnsen from Norway. Russia is the first at the world, Rosalia Nastatinova. 4.04, very good speed by the Russian. Now in for Denmark, Mie Nielsen, the backstroke European champion. And now it is Netherlands, Russia, Denmark. Kim Busch for the Netherlands, so this time no Ranomi Kromowidjojo, neither Femke Heemskerk, but they will probably be in the lineup come the finals. Netherlands, Denmark, Russia, and the last takeover with Emily Beckmann, very strong for the home team, also Maria Kamenieva for the Russians. But it is going to be Team Netherlands to take this heat ahead of the Russians and the Danish quartet.
Netherlands, 137.14,
a lot better time than in the previous heat by Italy. So, the best time in total. Nice win by the Dutch, Kira Toussaint, the backstroker, back in action. And waiting for the turn of Kromowidjojo and Heemskerk in the final. Five teams under 140. In this heat. So, Netherlands fastest qualifier. Russia, Denmark, Italy, Sweden, France, Norway and Hungary just edging out the Finnish team in 8th position. And coming up, the swim-off for the final spot in the semi-final of the 50-meter freestyle for men. We have Turkey's Emre Sakci in lane 4 and Maxim Lobanovski from Hungary in 5. Going against each other for that last and final spot. A better start by Sakci, but it is going to be very close. Turning first, it is Lobanovski now. But a better turn by Sakci, who is just a few inches ahead of Lobanovski. Can the Hungarian find some extra speed? Yes, he can. He takes it. Does he? Yes. 21.18. Very good time by the Hungarian, so he moves through to the semi-final in this event. The semi-final will be contested at the beginning of the afternoon program, and then the final of the 53 will conclude the events today. An incredible night to follow, so make sure to tune in at 5 p.m. Central European time. That is when the coverage from the 19th European Short Course Championship continues. See you there.